What's up, yo, bumpy ass road, y'all?
What is good?
So I have been vlogging. I have not been editing. So this video is gonna be like a bunch of random clips. Kind of, there's really no topic for this video. What I have planned in my idea, this is how this video is gonna work. You're gonna see a bunch of random clips. You're gonna see me at the beginning of this video. You're gonna see me at the end of this video. And then the next video, I'm literally gonna start it from
like now,
as I'm driving to work. This is the introduction. Hope you guys enjoyed all these random clips of the past 2 weeks, I believe. So, hope you enjoy. Have fun. Hey, can you help the boy out? She messed up her whiskers. It was funny. Ah, fuck, that's a door.
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June. I said that's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down. 'Cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over.
It's... oh shit. It's early as fuck. Or it seems like it. It's not too bad. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. It's 45 degrees here in Vegas, which in Vegas, that's like below zero for Las Vegas natives. But it's Saturday. I'm gonna take you guys on through my Saturday journey, which consists of nothing. This is just like my life. I woke up this morning, this early, go run with some fellow competitors in this half marathon that I'm doing. That's like two other people, but I think it's only gonna be me and someone else. Thing is, it's far. Where he wants to go run, it's half an hour away from where I live. That's far. I don't wanna do it, but I'm going to, because mom did not raise a bitch. So it's time to go meet up with them, and we're gonna get our cardio in. So I'll meet you guys at the at our location of where we will be running. Good morning, Dad.
Good morning.
Good morning, Dad.
You late, dude?
I changed my sweater though.
Uh huh.
Yeah,
Oh my god. It is. It's a nice sunrise. It's cute. So we go around this big ass mountain.
Yeah.
That's cool, dude. I'm so tired. Last night I went out with my parents. There's just always like Day of the Dead festival by the house. We were eating, but I was like freezing and I couldn't breathe because my nose was all stuffed up. And so I still feel that way right now. So probably once I start running, it'll clear up. My sprinting gear on, I'm not gonna sprint. Make sure my truck is locked.
Yeah, it's just like this part, it sucks because it's all like this steady incline all the way around. And once you get behind the mountain,
it's all downhill. Like
a chill downhill. Majority of it's downhill, which is good. It's just the worst part for me, honestly, was right down there. Because I'm like, it come down fast, and then as soon as you get to the bottom, it's like, oh. It fucking sucks.
Cool. I was getting ready. I woke Salisa up and she's like, "You're really gonna go dressed like that?" And I was like, "Yeah, leave me alone." Because I was dressed up as a highlighter.
Look at that.
I got the blue sweater on. I got my neon yellow greenish highlighter looking yoga pants, stretchy pants with the teeth. Oh shit. With teeth socks, bro. Looking like a fucking highlighter. Wash these hoes. I'm coming for these hoes. That way they know I'm coming and they know I'm single. Ooh. Or not single. They know I'm taken.
Nike says I had to go for a long run and I had to go
10
miles.
Oh, I'm done. 10 miles?
That's what my phone says. Alright, let's do this.
Midway check. How many miles are we at?
7.
Fucking hell. Timing? A little over an hour.
Yep. Not bad.
Which isn't bad. Because it's the longest I've ever run. My calves are fucking hurting a lot. But one more mile will be at 9 miles.
One more lap.
What did I say?
1 more mile.
Math.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to run this last mile without stopping. My last lap. I don't know why I keep saying mile. I'm going to try to run this last one without stopping. Then we'll see from there. After this, I need to get gas. I won't make it home.
I just want to go back to sleep.
No, I got shit to do today. Last mile.
Last lap.
I'll probably call it then. Let's go. Alrighty then. Back from the run. And let me fill you guys in on how that went. Cardio sucks. Stupid. I don't know why people do it for fun. But overall, it was a great workout. And I did kind of enjoy it. Overall, I liked it. It was a good run. I was proud of my pace. But I wasn't completely satisfied because I wish I could do more. A few things that I wanted to discuss about was when doing a run, I did not know that your body could get that physically tired. My calves started cramping up. I felt it in my hamstrings, my quads, my feet. Felt it a lot, but overall I did about 9 miles in about an hour 30 or so, hour 35, around there. A lot of fun. As you guys met, Cody is my coworker. And he's done, I forgot my water in the trunk. I should probably get that. He's done half marathons before, so he kind of knows what to do when it comes to things like that. Pace is very important when it comes to running. So now, since that is done, I gotta go get gas because I know for a fact I won't make it home. And so, time to go to Costco, and then I'll probably see you guys in the next clip. So I'll see you guys back once I get home. ¿Está bueno, mamá?
Comete algo, dile.
Muy bueno.
¿Quieres un pedazo? ¿Comprado la mano?
¿Está bueno?
¿Good?
¿Cocina?
Ajá. Tiene de este tazajo. Estíralo, agárralo todo.
What's the verdict?
¿Está bueno?
¿Good?
We're pretty good.
So tell me, where are you at?
Day of the Dead.
Explain to us what this is.
It's like in Mexico, people die. Only in Mexico. And then, yeah, that's it. Today's their day. Like President's Day? Same thing. There's some good stuff though. Mom, Dad. Horchata's really good too. You know what's really good? This sweater by Ghost.
Turn around, show it off. Move your cap.
Really soft, affordable. Look, puberty, affordable. It's not a brand deal, so Ghost, you owe me money. Do your name.
Grandma and grandpa
from. Yeah. You look like a chola.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
But a cute one.
It's the beanie. Would you agree that tacos are the best food that exists in life?
Lower 1-1.
Hey there, buddy. How's it going?
I would say tacos are the greatest. Is the greatest food known to man and exist in life, honestly. You know how people judge other people based off of like their sign? I judge people based on what kind of tacos they get.
What's your sign again?
I'm a Leo, so I'm the best one there's. So if you're just a person who likes like
Gemini and Leo compatibility and sex, love and life.
I know my thought. I was gonna say if you guys don't pick like exotic types of meat, like I have tripe.
I don't pick exotic meats.
I pick exotic types of meat.
That's rude.
So I'm judging you.
You've been with me for almost a year and a half now.
I've been judging you since we started dating. You get pastor, which is good.
Get away.
I fucks with pastor. But if you don't try like those exotic foods.
Interesting.
Like tripe. Which is intestines. Buche is like the inside part of your cheek. Lingua is a cow tongue. Cabeza is like the fat around your head.
I'm gonna throw up.
Yeah. That's the good shit.
Okay.
If you don't get any of that, you're probably.
Not necessarily.
This is my thought.
Because what if you can't get it? You're allergic.
That's different. Okay. That's
but
different.
See?
No.
Kind of just base it upon that stuff.
I can base it off exactly that. So if you don't get these types of food, one, you probably eat ass. It's not pertaining to you, because I know you don't. Two, you're probably like, if you're a girl, you're probably like a slutty six who does only missionary.
Bitch.
And then if you're a guy who doesn't get that types of meat, then you ride your girlfriend. That's all I have to say about that.
That's what you do.
I enjoy these tacos. Tripe is the best one. None of these compared to my dad's tacos. I'm not saying that.
Disregard what I said.
What do I do?
Sound greatly, but it is there. They usually have this idea to change the world and make it a better place, and this can drive their Gemini partner crazy in case they don't have enough room for their own opinions. Emotions. We're at 85%. The warm, fat Leo is bitch. That Leo is prepared to give to their Gemini partner will hardly leave them indifferent. While the childish nature of Gemini is going to spark wonderful emotions in Leo day after day. Babe, I spark wonderful emotions in you.
Mm-hmm.
Sip your fucking horse shit.
It was horchata made out of real horse.
Oh, you're right there. I didn't see you guys. How you guys doing? If you guys watched the whole video, thank you guys. Like I say at the end of all my videos, if you watch these, I appreciate all of you. To the new subscribers, to the ones that left, I highly doubt you'll still watch this video. But thank you guys for watching. Now I'm literally going to start my next video right now. So I'll see you guys probably sometime this week. Yeah, so thanks, guys.